टॉपिक इज फूड कॉस्ट फॉर एस्टेब्लिशमेंट आई एग्जीक्यूटिव शेफ और एग्जीक्यूटिव शू शेफ आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर शन टू कैलकुलेटिंग द फूड कॉस्ट ओके सो वॉट इज फूड कॉस्ट फूड कॉस्ट इज टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ फूड कंज्यूम्ड माइनस स्टाफ फूड कॉस्ट ओके स्टाफ फूड कॉस्ट इज इन द लेबर कॉस्ट सो वी डिडक्ट स्टाफ फूड कॉस्ट फ्रॉम द फूड कॉस्ट ओके Now why we calculate food cost? First, to ascertain the food cost of particular item on the menu, to know the cost for a particular item of our menu, or to fix the cost of particular item on our menu. To ascertain the total expenditure on food over a period of time. To know what are the total cost we expend on food in our establishment. Okay, we calculate food cost to know what are the total cost we expend on food in our establishment. Third thing is help in fixing of price and profit margin on the product. Okay, it's help. To fix a price of a particular product, okay. To fix a price of a particular product and helps to fix a profit margin on this product, okay. It helps to fix the price of a particular product and helps to fix the profit margin of a particular product. Helps in controlling wastage. So wastage, when wastage happens. When you overpurchase the ingredients or when you're doing overproduction, that time wastage happens. Okay. When you control your food cost at that time, you know what are the total amount you have to purchase or you have to produce. So at that time, the number of wastage will be zero or something. Next thing is help in customer satisfaction. Okay, when your cost of wastage will be less, at that time you can reuse this cost for develop your product. Okay, when your wastage cost will be less, at that time you can reuse this wastage cost in your product for development purpose. At that time customer will be satisfied. Next thing is it's evaluate pricing and establish future pricing. Okay, market value will be continuously changed. Okay, market value will be continuously changed. At that time you have to change your pricing. So for the calculating of food cost, you can easily evaluate your pricing and you can change your pricing according to the market value. And the last thing is helps in improve quality of the product. That's like when you control your wastage, you can reuse or you can easily add this cost of wastage for developing your product. Okay, so those are the objectives for food cost calculation. And increasing food cost. First thing, incorrect billing. Okay, incorrect billing, because just I give an example. Suppose price of a particular dish is 70 rupees, okay, and you printed in bill it's 7 rupees, then discrepancies happen and food cost will be high. Portion too large. When you serve larger portion than the standardized recipe, okay, at that time your wastage cost will be high, just because of guests are doing wastage with that extra portion. Okay, and your food cost will be high. Inefficient staffs. when your staff's inefficient, suppose your staff's not maintain the standardized recipe, your staff's not properly skilled, at that time they're doing too much wastages and they serve too large portions, okay, and your wastage will be high and food cost will be also high. Next thing is wastage. Next, fault in record keeping. Suppose you not take the received copy of a particular good, okay, when you purchase a good, at that time you don't keep the received copy, okay, then the amount of this good will be vanished from your record, okay, the amount of your good will be vanished from your record just because of you can't take the received copy, okay, and discrepancies happen and your food cost will be high. Next, dishonest practice. Okay, dishonest practice means when your staffs are dishonest, okay, when they steal money from the cash counters, okay, when they steal goods, at that time discrepancies happen and your food cost will be high. So those are the reasons behind the increasing food cost. Control your food cost. First thing is, all purchase must be controlled. When you over purchasing, at that time your food cost will be high just because of your cost of leftover items will be high. For that reason your closing stock will be high, and for that reason your next day opening stock will be also high. Okay, at that time you know that the food formula of food cost is equal to your cost of opening stock plus cost of purchase minus cost of purchase returns minus staff food cost. Okay, so it will be effect in your food cost, it will be effect in your opening stock, and your food cost will be high. So if you want to control your food cost, at first you have to control your purchasing. All purchase receipt copy must be recorded. Okay, when you purchase an item you should take the purchase receipt copy also, and you have to keep record this just because of it is the only proof of your purchase cost. Okay, next thing is, stop overproduction of food. When you overproduce or you doing the overproduction of a food, at that time your the wastage cost will be high. Okay, when you overproduce something or doing overproduction, at that time your wastage cost will be high. At that time it will be effect in your food cost, and your food cost will be also high. Next, efficient cash control system need in cashier department. Okay, next, up to date cost in daily basis, because your in opening stock, your closing stock will be changed daily basis at that time. For this reason you should up to date with your food cost, because the food cost formula, food cost is equal to opening stock, cost of opening stock plus cost of purchase minus cost of purchase return minus staff food cost. So your opening stock will be changed in daily basis, so you should up to date with your food cost, just because of your opening stock and the closing stock will be changed daily basis. Next, trending profit and loss account should be up to date, should be prepared and up to date. Okay, so by these things you can control your food cost, formula of food cost. So from the definition we know, cost of total food consumed minus cost of staff food is equal to your food cost. Okay, so we deduct staff food just because of it is in the labor cost, so we deduct the staff food cost from the total food cost. Now we have to break this cost of total food consumed. Cost of total food consumed is equal to cost of opening stock plus cost of purchase minus cost of purchase return. Okay, so what is opening stock? Opening stock means your previous day closing stock. Opening stock is equal to the closing stock or the closing goods of your previous day, which you can waste. So you have to reuse it, you have to use it in your next day. So that will be your opening stock of your next day. So that is opening stock. Okay, so cost of total food consumed is equal to cost of opening stock plus cost of purchase. Cost of purchase means the cost of goods you purchase minus cost of purchase return. Cost of purchase returns mean cost of goods you return after the purchase. Cost of good return after the purchase. So cost of total food consumed is equal to cost of opening stock, which is your closing stock of your previous day, plus cost of purchase. Cost of purchase means the goods you purchase minus cost of purchase return. The goods, cost of the goods, your returns after the purchasing. Okay, so that is your cost of total food consumed. So now the formula will be food cost is equal to cost of opening stock plus cost of purchase minus cost of purchase return minus cost of staff food. Okay, so it is your final food cost formula. Now what is the formula of total cost? Okay, total cost is equal to material cost. Material cost is food cost, beverage cost, tobacco or cigarette cost, etc. Okay, that is your material cost. Food cost plus beverage cost plus tobacco and your cigarette cost. That is your material cost plus labor cost plus overhead cost. Overhead cost is equal to rent, repairs, supply, taxes, telephone bills, other bills, etc. Miscellaneous cost, that is your overhead cost. So total cost is equal to material cost, which is food cost, beverage cost, tobacco and cigarette cost, etc., plus labor cost plus overhead cost. Overhead cost means rent, repairs, supplies, taxes, telephone bills, etc. So that is your total cost of a establishment. So what is cost sheet or statement of food cost? After calculating the food cost, you have to put this cost in a sheet like a statement. Okay, that is your statement of food cost or cost sheet. A cost sheet contains these four things: total food cost, the amount of total food cost, cost per portion, profit percentage, what is your profit percentage on the total food cost, and selling price, what will be your selling price of the product. It contains total food cost, total amount of food cost, cost of per portion, what is the cost of per portion, per portion means per customer or per guest. So that is cost per portion. Profit percentage means what will be your percentage on total food cost, profit, total percentage of profit on your total food cost, and selling price. Selling price is what will be your selling price of a particular product. Okay, so you have to write down this fourth thing in your cost sheet. Okay,